transcribed and captioned media program in the classroom and online. DCMP.org.
It was great seeing you all at the Deaf Bowling last night and hearing about your plans to get in better shape. More importantly, I'm thrilled you showed up this morning because people often talk about goals for working out and are motivated but never follow through. You all showed up and seem ready to go. I'd like to tell you a little bit about myself. I like to get my workouts done early in the day whenever I can, because if I don't, the next thing I know, the day is gone and I've missed my chance. So I make it a priority to work out in the morning. My wife, on the other hand, is different. She prefers to work out later in the day when she's finished her chores. For example, we have a big dog. And when she washes him, she really has to wrestle and get soaked every time. She gets a bit annoyed, and a way for her to relax and unwind is to work out. But remember, everyone's different, so do what you prefer. I've never liked exercising. I always put it off and feel like it's a waste of time. Of course, my doctor tells me that my bones are suffering for having done so little exercise all my life. She also noted that my blood glucose is higher than normal. Now I have early stage diabetes. She said becoming more active would help to reduce the sugar in my blood. She also said that losing weight would help. She's hopeful that I can control my diabetes with exercise and a proper diet and avoid needing to take medication. Hey, that sounds like what my mom's got. She said her bones were getting weak and she's developing osteoporosis. She couldn't explain it to me very well, but I got the impression that it was part of the natural aging process, and there was nothing she could do about it, so I shouldn't worry. No, that's not true. According to my doctor, if I start exercising a few times a week, I have a good chance of slowing down the process of bone loss and maybe even help make my bones stronger. She said that if I don't get exercise regularly, then it will become a serious problem.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.